Yes.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, the roof, I had tarred it yesterday, and it's still leaking, so that was while it was wet. It's still wet. It's just been wet. So maybe that's why the tar didn't seal. But just gonna have to work with it for now. Going to get some fresh firewood here and a few exhaust parts I got. These are some Flow Pro twister resonators. Got some cedar wood and a couple pieces of hardwood.
Terrible.
got the fire going. So we were going to purchase a proper metal brake, heavy duty, about 8 feet, but it sold too quickly and we didn't get it, so that's okay, because just be something big in the way for now, and there's other ways I can do it. So I had this metal frame piece that I cut off something. It wasn't being used. Now I'm gonna place it over top of this. I'm gonna get a rag and just dry off the moisture. That's the problem with the leaks in here now, because it's just letting all the moisture go into air in here. So at least when I turn the fire on, it gets a bit of rid of a bit of the moisture. Let's get started. Get more
Jen stepped in to give her the kitchen of her dreams. Our 4-ply LVL is done, our point loads are done, which leads us to our ceiling joists. So we're going to be sistering our ceiling joists today. It's going to be a nice busy day of framing, but shortly after that we'll be drywall here, right, Paul?
And not quite. The existing ceiling joists we're going to sister.
Yeah.
Too twisted.
Okay.
It's not going to work, so we have to just cut them all out. We're going to put the 2x8s in anyway, so we'll just put them in without sistering.
I guess it wouldn't be a renovation if something didn't go wrong. Everything's going nice and smooth, and then we find out, okay, we have to take out the rest of the ceiling joists. Not a big deal.
The big deal would be the cut that they have in the existing hip of the roof,
which should be one long, solid piece. Instead, they took 2 pieces, spliced it, and sandwiched it together, which created a weak point in our structure. So their fix for that was to put a single 2x4 transferring down on a double 2x6 over about a 15-foot span, which is completely wrong. In order to fix that, we're going to put in a new beam made of a 3 2x10s, and then we'll put 3 2x8s right under the splice so that the weight load will be transferred down to the new beam and we won't have to worry about that roof anymore.
Sounds good, let's do it.
Okay. There's no real load on the twisted rafter because the drywall has been broken, so it's a time to drop and cut them out and replace them. Once that's done, it's onto the new beam. Once we get the second 2x10 up, we'll nail it every foot for added strength, and we'll do the same for the third board. We are overkill here, but we like to go home to last.
Ellie only really loves 3 things: her family, her kitchen, and her view. So, she's already finished the kitchen. She already knows everything she wants. Why don't you do something for the view? And I need to do something with the family. What do you want us to do? I was like, oh, yeah, you tell me, because I'm not sure where.
Some of us just have a little bit of trouble. What are brothers for?
Welcome back.
close. We're one step closer to Ellie's dream kitchen. The new cabinets arrived today, but first, our flooring contractor with a new subfloor and hardwood. I can't help much till they're done, so I'm taking a break to work on my special project. I'm off to a really cool space that's all about cutting-edge digital fabrication, and they're gonna help me design Ellie's one-of-a-kind bench. Steve.
Hey, Mike, how you doing?
I'm doing very well. How are yourself? Yeah, so I'm working on a project for a very special moment. What I've done here is I've actually gotten her children, her grandkids, all to write special messages. I was hoping we could machine them into this bench form. Ladies have something like this. So I kind of want to just lay it out randomly, but in a way that it's going to work, obviously.
Yeah, we've got a software program that will actually take the image just the way you see it. Mm-hmm. And it'll do it with my phone. The software program basically takes the image and it converts it into lines of the machine.
Okay.
So now we do it.
Once the layout and sizing is right, the computer takes over and generates the data it needs to control the machine and produce the pictures. We're going to go, man. Here we go. All that's left is sit back and watch as it works its magic.
Device so I can make sure I'm getting the angle that I want.
Thank you.
myself, this isn't a big deal. I can handle it. Then I ask myself, my dad's coming. It's going to become a big deal. You're walking in already with this, like, oh, you've messed up, Mr. Holmes. My dad wanted the end of the cabinet to sit on the stair.
The first thing I see is that cabinet exceeds the drain. The steps needed to grow further to adapt to the cabinet, the depth of the cabinet, which I said how many times. Pretty sure I said, check the depth of the cabinet. It must be the same distance as the step. The tread, that cabinet sits on that step. That would dictate the depth of the step.
Yes, there you go.
It's not like I was dreaming. I said it.
Honestly, this one falls on me. There's a lot going on in here. I thought we communicated that, but now the cabinets are made. No going back. I don't waste your time. Now we have to come up with a solution.
I'm not from the world I told you so, because that's not what I want to do. You don't win wars, battles by I told you so. You need to be able to look at this and go, I see this coming. It's a team effort. It's about listening. It's about, I get, okay, I get that, I understand that, I'm going to be on top of that. That's how you learn.
Let me think about this for a second and concentrate on something else. I'm going to see what Sherry is doing.
Sherry is downstairs.
She's downstairs.
We're working on her front. I haven't seen it yet, but maybe you want to check it out.
Okay. I'll be back.
Okay.
No big deal. We'll figure it out. My kids are still young. They're still learning. The next generation is not perfect. No one's perfect.
Sherry?
What are you doing down there?
Just, you know, slack it off, sit down.
Here's my phone, accepting, swallowing all this, oh, here's dad, I'm gonna get trapped, I should have got this, and then I can see him actually trying to mimic me. Oh, shit. I'm asking,
oh, where is it?
I have that young man.
She doesn't want to show me, which tells me it's screwed up, you gotta fix it.
No, you can't.
Why can't I see it?
That's
cool. Her reaction was quite simple. Get out.
I want him to assume the worst. He already thinks I did something bad anyway and made a mistake. So now, I'm going to surprise him by being like, look what I made.
Now he thinks I made a mistake.
Okay, I think I know what we have to do here.
For every mistake, there's a solution. And it's really just having the talent to fail. What do we need to do? How do we actually manipulate this? That if most properly,
you'll have to create a manuscript here. It'll be a 3-inch recess. Come across the windows and the floor. That way the water is going to touch the floor here. And it'll look like one or the other, whether the cabinet's on top of the step or the step is going to the top.
Right. My dad comes in, makes a big deal out of it, and then in the end, this will work. That won't be terrible.
Got it?
Yeah, got it. So, the small problem that Dad made into a big problem is literally going to take 20 minutes to fix.
It's like a club. All we have left to do is put a back behind here, secure the tape there, make sure that it stays nice and strong. It's an easy solution, looks elegant. Once the countertop goes on, this kitchen's almost done.
Thank you.
All right, that worked a lot better putting this clamp the other direction too. It's nice.
Thank you.
another one. Done. The piece of metal held down a lot better with these vices flipped over. It's a bit riffled from the cutter, metal cutter that I used, because it wasn't cutting a perfectly straight line. It's pretty straight, but that's not a problem because the corner will be pretty much perfectly straight, and then these will just be able to be pushed up and welded into place where it's needed. So I can take this side off and see how it looks on the other side. See if I can.
Dude,
this piece of metal here. This piece of metal up there. So I can. There's not too much smoke. Just makes a lot more heat come out with the doors open. But then it starts filling up with smoke a bit.
Now, there's a few things whenever you're doing this type of work that you need to consider. It's kind of like the width or how far apart you want your wrenches. If you get with some smaller wrenches, you know, it'd be fine to have them closer together. But as the wrench size goes up, well, they need to be a little further apart for some better clearance. We've got about 2 inches, but I think 2 inches. All right, we're pretty much ready to start making our marks so that we can hang our hooks. What we're planning to hang from all those is 7 millimeter wrenches all the way to 20. That means we need 14 of them. Now, to do that, you could use a tape measure, but I have to say, sometimes math can be a little bit complicated whenever you start in 2 1/4, kind of like that. So to simplify things, I made me a cool little piece of aluminum. That's the exact width of that. All you gotta do is lay it up there, make your mark.
Exactly the same as the other side.
Another one.
So what I'll do first is, what I've got to do is clean this up along the line. And start tying this up or part in place. Thank you. go. Throw out the generator, other generator, for the power tools here. Break off any loose parts, low hanging edges that I see here. This stuff. Push it up and break it off. Thank you.
Thank you.
packed up first. The line that I use as a guide on the rocker. I got my corner lined up on that side how I want it. It's tacked from the middle to the corner, keeping the gaps tight. And then I'm gonna do the same over here. Push this in and lift it up as well, so it lines up better with this front fender. That so I can push this gap in so it's tight, and this gap here as well. Other than that, it's looking very nice. Oh, I'll close this back. All that has to be done is pulling this up a bit more. So it'll line up with that back part there. And same with the front, and then the middle as well. And tack all that in place. we're going to grind out the back sides here on the corners. So I can push the back up, push it into place, and hold it and pack it in there with the holder. Thank you.
got that side welded in. And then we're gonna do this side.
Thank you.
That's looking nice. Slip that on there. Tacked it all in. I can do more solid welds, or you could also body fill up the joints if you wanted to. All that has to be done here is checking out the inside and seeing where I can hold it in place and weld it, and put some pieces, vertical pieces, for the inside part. It might be a good idea to put a straight edge piece of metal here first, because this is pretty wavy, and if it's hanging down, you'll notice. But if you have footsteps there, it wouldn't really matter anyways. See, like, this is curved over and lines looking pretty good. Same with this. I'm gonna go to this other side now. Start with this side.
Thank you.
Got the base surface all grinded down.
Kind of reflect the welder in and position this other side with the plates.
Thank you. right, here's this side done too. I'm getting a little bit lower here, but it's because of the back parts that have those ripples in them. But that's okay. It's painted black, it's hard to see. This side's pretty similar, so that's okay. Okay, well, there's both rockers welded on in about 2 hours. Just have to go back and I can do a continuous weld along the entire length, slowly, by spot welding it, so it doesn't get too deformed if I do it all at once. Then there's a couple soft spots where I'll just put other patches of metal around the outsides. This side was a bit better condition than the other side. This is all surface rust here, but you better just have this like covered in metal or aluminum. Objective was to put the rockers on, and that's how I do it.